How's it going?
Hi, I'm Jason Cirillo. Welcome to Peek Poke, sponsored by RoboTube Games. This is our flagship episode, and basically on the show what we're going to do is sort of dissect and take a look at some old, retro, and obscure game titles, and sort of give quick reviews of them and kind of go over their functionality. What we have today in the glorious and world-famous Retro Bar, which is really neither glorious or world-famous, we have the full line behind me here of Coleco tabletop arcade games, and these are really cool electronic games that Coleco produced starting in 1981. They are near perfect replicas of their full-size arcade counterpart. Behind me you can see them. Here we have Donkey Kong Jr., Pac-Man, Donkey Kong, Galaxian, Miss Pac-Man, Frogger, and the king of them all, Zaxxon, which is just only slightly smaller than an actual Zaxxon arcade machine. The machine is very well put together. It has everything from the marquee, which is unlit, of course, to the side panel art, as well as some really excellent artwork inside the machine, like the arcade bezels, which go alongside of the monitors. So let's take a look at some of the gameplay. The first machine we're going to take a look at is Donkey Kong Jr. And you'll notice right off the bat that this machine differs greatly in terms of its body style from the rest of the machines. And there's a reason for this. Nintendo originally had planned to create a Donkey Kong Jr. game of its own based on the arcade game, styled after the rest of these machines here in terms of its body shape, etc. And at the last minute, Coleco decided to scrap the idea, though a prototype was built. They actually went and took Nintendo's tabletop Game Watch and just rebranded it with the Coleco name for the United States market. So you can actually find out there on eBay two of these Donkey Kong machines. One is a Nintendo branded machine and the other one is Coleco branded. The Coleco one looks way cooler than the Nintendo one with the side art and the nice orange case. So if you have a choice, definitely go with the Coleco one. It's really cool. Gameplay wise, I would say that it's not really an arcade conversion. You'll notice that there's a lot of differences from the arcade game. You're floating around on balloons and umbrellas and all this other crazy stuff. The premises is pretty much the same, but the gameplay itself is pretty different. It's a lot of fun. It's one of the coolest in the Coleco line. I would definitely have to give it 3.5 stars out of 5. Docking a little bit of points for not being a straight arcade conversion, but that's just the nerd in me. Can't help it. The next one we're going to take a look at is Donkey Kong, which is the prequel, of course, to Donkey Kong Jr. Another great machine, great looking design, bezel artwork, side artwork, marquee artwork, everything just as the arcade machine was, and a fantastic conversion of the Nintendo machine all around. The gameplay is, to put it bluntly, really difficult. I have a lot of time playing this machine. I just find it really hard. Maybe it's just me, maybe I just suck. I mean, that's entirely possible. But anyway, it's a great arcade conversion. Weird sounds, but nonetheless pretty good. Donkey Kong kind of looks like Grimace. A pretty good game. I give it 3 out of 5 stars. Definitely pick one up if you can find it on eBay. The next machine that we have in the series is Namco's Pac-Man, and this was like the original, and I can just remember being in first grade and this girl came into school with one of these things and I was so insanely jealous and I just wanted to steal it and take it home and sleep with it. That's kind of weird. It's a pretty good arcade conversion. Pretty much all the features in the arcade version are here. Plays pretty much like the arcade. I mean, not much else to say. The graphics are pretty primitive, but then the sound will just like drive you up a wall. Like, it's just maddening. But otherwise, not bad. Another 3 stars out of 5 for Pac-Man, I would say. Yeah. Next up, we have another Namco game, Galaxian. Probably Namco's probably better known for Galaga than it is for Galaxian, but this stands out as probably one of the best in the series in terms of arcade conversion. It's very, very well done. The sound effects are outstanding. The graphics are very, very good. It actually has two modes of play, which is really cool on this particular model. You can play Galaxian or you can play Space Invaders. It has a simulated Space Invaders game, pretty much like the original, just without the little bunkers at the bottom. Very, very solid game. Definitely pick one up if you can find one on eBay. 4.5 stars out of 5 on this one. Next up, Miss Pac-Man. Miss Pac-Man is, without a doubt, the rarest of these machines. I'm not exactly sure why, but it is among the rarest and will go for the most cash on eBay. It's a very good conversion of Miss Pac-Man. It's very, very similar to Pac-Man. The difference is that the sound effects are a little less grating than Pac-Man, maybe putting it up at a higher price because, man, those Pac-Man sound effects are rough. But the Miss Pac-Man machine is one of the best looking, too. I mean, the colors are just vibrant, and they just got the whole overall Miss Pac-Man branding just spot on. It just looks fantastic. 4.5 stars out of 5 for this one. Just a very sweet tabletop game. Looks great in any collection. And moving on, Frogger. This is just a classic. Everybody loves Frogger. And this conversion of the arcade game is excellent. Plays just like Frogger. I mean, you know, granted the graphics are a little bit primitive, but I mean, the gameplay I find is very, very similar to the Frogger arcade game, and it's a very good experience. I would definitely recommend this one, and take it anywhere you go, and you don't even need to hook it up to a car battery and drag it across the street. 10 points if you know what I'm talking about. Frogger's a great tabletop. I'm gonna give that one 5 stars out of 5. It's just awesome. And last but not least, we have the beast, Zaxxon. This thing is humongous. And it has this awesome joystick on it. I mean, it looks just like an arcade joystick. The Zaxxon machine actually uses two display panels, one on top of the other, and they're transparent. So you have like this 3D effect of like the ship flying over the landscape and shooting down the airplanes and all this other stuff. If you can find one of these, pick it up. And it's actually not that rare or that expensive. You can usually find one of these on eBay for about 40 bucks, which is really not that bad. Looks great in a collection. Excellent gameplay. Little bit on the difficult side, but still, it's a great machine. It has this great white noise sound as you fly your ship over the landscape. 4.5 stars out of 5 on Zaxxon. Very nice tabletop. That about wraps it up for this series of tabletop arcade conversions. However, it's interesting to note that Coleco planned on making a few more machines in 1982, and they appear, prototype photographs appeared in their 1982 catalog. It's too bad they never got released because they would have been really cool. They had planned an arcade conversion of Berserk, Omega Race, which had some neat looking rotating controllers on it, as well as, of course, the pre-mentioned Donkey Kong Jr., which still kind of went to production, just not in the Coleco casing. If you don't have a lot of money to spend and you don't feel like going through a bidding war on eBay, there is a company called Excalibur, which makes a lot of handheld like Sudoku and, you know, crossword puzzle LCD games to this day. And they just released a two of these sort of Coleco-looking replica machines. This one's Space Invaders, which is pretty neat because Space Invaders was never released in the original line of Coleco arcade games. And they have this pretty cool Space Invaders game, which plays a lot like Space Invaders and is backlit and everything. It's a really, really cool conversion. I have this here. You can get these for like $29 brand new. A couple of like specialty novelty stores carry them. And they're really cool. And they're just like the Coleco games. They have the side art and the you know, the panel artwork and everything else, the joystick. They're really cool. They also made a Frogger one, which uses like a top-down light projection, sort of like Donkey Kong does, and it plays a lot like the Frogger arcade game as well. I don't have that one here today. But, so, some newer tabletops you can get on the web if you've got a few bucks laying around. That's about it for this episode of Peek Poke, brought to you by Robotube Games. Visit us at www.robotubegames.com. Peace.